roads have white lines, yellow lines, even green lines. But orange.
Orange?
Orange?
That's got to be breaking some kind of rule, right?
You send me so many great questions about roads, and at the rate I make videos, it'll take years to answer them all. So I thought I'd take just a few minutes and answer one of your questions. A good one from Allan, a contributor on Patreon. I appreciate that. Allan writes, can you talk about orange construction zone paint? Ontario, Canada uses it. Allan, Ontario is one of the first places in North America where engineers are experimenting to see if they can make construction zones a little bit safer. Turns out drivers in construction zones kill 800 people a year, and that's just in the US.
Work zones are confusing. Crews keep restriping the zone to safely move drivers around heavy equipment, and cleaning up the old lines is rarely perfect.
Sometimes it's hard to know if you see a faint line. Is that really the line and it's just worn out? Or is it the ghost of an old line that shouldn't be there anymore? A driver might be distracted, might miss the sign that says it's a work zone, and so they'll just zoom right into it. Or they might get halfway through a construction zone, think it's over, and start speeding up or stop paying attention.
So to save lives, the idea would be that orange lines make it really easy to see where you need to go, and it keeps reminding you that, yeah, I am in a work zone.
Maybe I even need to slow down a little bit. Now, those orange lines are the same color as the cones and barriers the crews are already putting out anyway, but the question is, does it work?
Go, go, go. 107.9, the beat of Lexington. 107.9, the beat.
Kentucky hired a company to paint orange lines through its construction zone on Interstate 75 back in 2019.
They painted the orange stripe right on top of the existing yellow or white line.
Then researchers from the University of Kentucky observed the number of car crashes. And they found it actually went up a little bit overall, but the type of crashes that happened in the work zone were much less severe on average. Also, drivers didn't really seem to slow down that much compared to a typical work zone without orange striping, but researchers concede that the sample size is really too small for them to draw any conclusions. Yeah.
As for the lines themselves, the Kentucky Transportation Cabinet tried a water-based paint, and after 100 days it looks like this. So they also tried this spray on plastic, and it seems to hold up a lot better. But before Kentucky, Wisconsin tried orange paint when they rebuilt their big zoo interchange. Wintertime means dumping a lot of salt on the roads, and that jumbles up with the white lines and makes it hard to see. So engineers tried not just orange, but several types of orange to see what looked the best, and went with a fluorescent color.
But during the day, the UV from the sun wore out the paint faster than any of the other paints, so it's a trade-off.
But the real problem comes when the sun goes away.
It's more difficult to see the lines when it's dark and also when it's raining.
The orange lines are almost invisible.
On a dark highway, nothing shows up better than a white line. So what do you choose? Orange during the day or white at night? Well, why not have both?
KHTS FM, El Cajon, San Diego's hit music, channel 933.
California is trying this out down in San Diego County near Legoland, where California is building a new carpool lane on Interstate 5.
But instead of painting over the old white and yellow markings, crews are painting the orange off to the sides.
Testing two different kinds. One of them is orange alongside each of the white lines.
Striping the orange side to side.
Sort of like an orange Oreo cookie.
And don't forget to try the all-new grapefruit Oreo.
Tastes great with milk.
And orange preceding white to add contrast for drivers on the southbound side.
Stacking the orange vertically, just before the white line.
The theory being that contrasting orange helps a driver really see where they're supposed to go.
Using two side-by-side colors is nothing new. California already does this with a tastier, non-citrusy black and white Oreo cookie. But also back east on toll roads, where purple is the official color for tolling, the Federal Highway Administration allows purple and white stripes to be side-by-side. But back here with our orange creamsicle, where California engineers want to see if it works, they installed closed-circuit TV cameras to see how fast drivers are going and see how well people stay in their lane. Every 2 months, they'll use a reflectometer to see how well the lines are showing up at night, and a spectrometer to check daytime visibility. And after 1 year, California will take all this data and publish their results.
The orange lines in construction zones are cheap, easy, and just successful enough that you'll probably see more experiments around the country going forward as we figure out whether this thing works or not. Might even start to see it in your state. By the way, Allan, the first place in North America I can find, the very first place, is Ontario, Canada, where they tried putting down orange construction zone striping. So that explains why you've been seeing it. This video is made possible by very real people like you who kick in a couple bucks each month so I can research and answer questions like Allan's or like yours or do deep dives on big topics like this one here. Because if you sat through this video, you probably would wonder, why do road signs all look the same from coast to coast? I think you're gonna wanna click on that. It's gonna take 28 minutes, but it's worth it.